Hello, in this video I will be showing you the rotary evaporator and how we use it to evaporate solvents from samples that are dissolved in a solvent. This part up here consists of a condenser which is inside, and I don't know if you can see it, but there's a spiral in there. And when we turn the water on, hopefully you can see that there's water going through this condenser that's on the inside of this big glass tube. Because what's going to happen is we will attach a round bottom flask down here, and the round bottom flask has our sample in it. I'm not going to attach it quite yet, but that will be where the flask will go. The whole thing will be under a vacuum because it's attached to an aspirator over here, so we'll put the aspirator on it. And can either turn this so that it opens up, air comes in through here, or we can turn it this way, and now this joint is sealed. And now if I put my finger on this, I should have a vacuum established, and indeed it is sucking on my finger. And you can tell if there's a vacuum established in there. So now what I'm going to do is attach the round bottom flask with my sample in it and solvent. And I'm going to keep my hand on there for a few seconds until the vacuum gets established. You can kind of hear the water of the aspirator changes its tenor because it's down. And you can see that there's bubbles forming in there. In other words, that solvent, which happens to be ether, high ethyl ether, very volatile solvent, is literally boiling in this flask even though there's no heat. It's boiling in the flask because, as you remember, boiling temperature of liquids decreases as the pressure decreases, and so since that's under quite a bit of vacuum there, the solvent is boiling, but it's slowing down. So why does it not just keep on boiling? Partly because it gets very cold, and this is in fact very cold right now. The other thing I can do is turn on the rotary part of it, and what that does is forms a thin film of the solvent on the inside of the glass, and that gets sucked out. Every time that thin film forms, it gets sucked out of there. And you also notice it's very cloudy, and that's because it's getting very cold. Now if I run my hands over it, some of that cloudiness disappears because I'm literally melting it with my hand. Why should it get cold? Well, if you remember, evaporation is an endothermic process. Heat has to go into any material to convert it from liquid to a gas. It's always a positive delta H, because gas has more energy than liquid does. Endothermic, meaning heat's going into it. People always get confused by this. They think, well, if heat's going into it, why isn't it getting hot instead of getting cold? Well, if heat's going into the process, the heat is coming from somewhere. It's coming from the surroundings, specifically from the glass and from my hand and from my air around it and so on. I don't know if you can see it or not, but it's so cold that it actually forms a layer of ice on the outside of this. That cold temperature slows down the evaporation process. So what we're going to do is use this container. Just put some water in it. Doesn't even have to really warm up the water. Literally put the bulb in the bath of room temperature water. You may or may not be able to see it from where you are, but immediately that layer of ice melted on the outside, and the solvent is continuing to evaporate. We could make the water a little bit warmer if we wanted to, and that would make the solvent evaporate even better. You also may or may not be able to notice that there is a white powder forming on the inside of the ground bottom flask. That is the material that was dissolved in ether that we're trying to isolate from the ether. That happens to be aspirin. Aspirin dissolves pretty readily in ether, but as the ether is evaporating, of course, the aspirin is precipitating out and crystallizing out and forming on the outside of the flask. And I'm going to go ahead and remove the water bath. Just so we can see what's going on in there. And it's still getting pretty cold, which means ether is still evaporating. The question always arises, when do you know you're done? Well, basically, you know you're done when no more ether is evaporating. And the way you know no more ether is evaporating is that ether is going dry on the inside of the flask, or you can tell because it's not getting cold any longer. I'm going to go ahead. It is still getting cold in this case. I'm going to go ahead and just hold the water bath under here for a few more seconds. So now to stop it, we turn off the rotary aspect, we open. The vacuum up here. And we remove the flask. And you'll notice that we have a nice solid, the aspirin is in there, and the ether is evaporated up. Thank you for your attention.